Detective Tyler.
I'm Tyler.
And I'm Stoner.
Who asked?
What can we do for you?
I'd like some information about an arrest you made last night. A young black man by the name of Leon Washington.
Oh, that's our friend with the fresh mouth.
You'll excuse me, I was addressing Detective Tyler.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. It's just my want to be helpful.
Do you have the file over there?
Yeah. Here it is.
What's it doing over there?
Couldn't resist it. It's such an interesting case.
Well, there isn't much to tell, really. Mr. Washington was part of an illegal gambling operation, which we raided last night. He was part of the catch. That's about it.
That's about it.
I'd like to see him, please.
Oh, I don't think that's a very hot idea, lady.
Why not?
Oh, we've got a very angry young man down there in that tank. I think you should give him some time to cool off. I mean, he's so mad, he could be dangerous. He might even do, bodily harm, and that wouldn't do.
I don't think that's very likely.
Look, if you're his girlfriend, I have to tell you, you've made an unfortunate choice.
This may come as a rather rude shock to you, Mr.
Stoner.
Right. But I am not his girlfriend. I am his attorney. As a matter of fact, you haven't been too enthusiastic about anything lately. What's the matter? Are things getting too rough down at the Rock Garden?
No, Rock Garden's going great. I tell you, being an owner is the same thing as being a waitress. The only difference is they keep everything except the tips. Forsaking all others?
Have you reached a verdict, Miss Bannister?
Yes, I suppose I have.
Wait! Your Honor, I object!
Calvin!
Who are you? I'm a police officer, and I'm here
on
to
what
arrest this woman.
On what charge?
What? Grand larceny. She's stolen my heart.
Objection! Your Honor, objection!
Restrain that man!
Order in the court. Dee Dee Bannister, it is the judgment of this court that you will accept the marriage proposal of Julius Newcomb as the only proper and sensible course in your life. Now say I will. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it.
I will.
No, that money doesn't settle the case. It's just an assurance that he'll show up for trial. Yes, it is terribly important. So if you hear from him, tell him to call me immediately. He has both numbers. Yes, if he doesn't show up, it could be very bad for him. Okay, thank you. Goodbye.
You got troubles, huh?
Troubles? Oh, no, my new client, Marcus Williams, may have jumped bail, that's all.
That always makes the case more difficult.
It gets worse. I'm the one who raised his bail.
Dee Dee, that's terrible. How many times have I told you, when you tell a joke, hit the punchline? It gets worse. I'm the one who raised bail.
This is no joke. I got a $10,000 bail bond, and if he doesn't show up, I'm the one who has to pay it back.
You're not kidding.
No, I'm not.
That is the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. What did you go and get bail for?
Just a kid, Cliff. It never occurred to me that he'd run out like that. Just hope. Maybe he just spent the night with some friends or something last night. No, I have this horrible feeling that he just ran away.
In a Cracker Jack's box? Where does it say that a lawyer puts a bail for his client?
Cliff, he was desperate. His mother was desperate, and there's just the two of them. His father ran out on him when he was just a kid. And she's sick most of the time, and she doesn't have any Social Security. She won't go on welfare. Marcus is their only source of income.
Yeah, he supports the family by robbing old ladies.
This was his first offense.
This was the first time he was caught, you mean.
Oh, great. Now you sound just like Calvin.
Calvin is not always wrong, Dee Dee.
Cliff, Marcus had already been in jail for almost 2 weeks in that miserable facility out on Walton Island. I thought if he were out on bail, at least he could work until the trial.
So you, having all the money in the world, just wrote out a check for $10,000.
I did nothing of the kind. I went to a bail bondsman.
But you're responsible for that money if he runs out on you, which apparently he has. How you gonna come up with that money, huh? You can't even come up with rent.
Is that a hint, landlord?
Look, Dee Dee, suppose it was his first offense. What did he do? What did he do? Dee Dee, what was the charge?
Attempted robbery and assault.
On a woman 74 years old. And suppose she dies from that assault, huh? What do you have then? You got murder one. A good DA in this town has a very good one. Could make that stick without batting an eyelash.
So you think that Marcus skipped town to avoid trial, is that it?
Mm-hmm.
You think I made a big mistake, don't you?
I think you may spend the first 5 years of your career paying back that big mistake.
I know he's gonna show up. He's gotta come back.
Certainly hope so, Dee Dee. You got the name of the bail bondsman?
Here.
Oh, great! You would have to deal with him. I'll give him a call. Good night.
Thanks a lot, Cliff. I think.
Look, if you can't come up with rent this month, don't let it worry you. I'll take it out in legal advice.
Oh, great. You'd be a big loser then.
Without money. I got to travel.
I've already been through today's mail, Marcus, so why don't you just put that thing down?
Any checks in that mail, lady?
You'll only make it worse for yourself.
My problem's gonna be over just as soon as you give me some money so I can blow this town.
You know, you've got one hell of a nerve. You already stuck me with a $10,000 bail bond.
So what's a few more bucks between friends? Walk over some more cash, put on my tab.
Marcus, you've got to give yourself up.
Thanks for the suggestion.
They'll catch you, you know that.
I got friends who'll take care of me. All I got to do is get to them.
If you run away now, you'll be running for the rest of your life.
If I don't run away, I'm good for a nice long stretch. The rent is right, but everything about the deal stinks. So no thank you, lady.
You know, I might be able to work something out with the DA. He's a friend of mine. It might not be so bad for you.
If you don't give me some money right now, you ain't gonna have to worry about paying back no $10,000 or anything else, because you're gonna be one dead lawyer.
A plan of yours isn't going to work. Face it and give yourself up.
I'm not going back to jail. No way. Come on, you're supposed to be one of those smart college ladies. You figured out how to get your hands on that 10 grand. Might have enough brains in that pretty head to figure out how to get some more.
Don't you know anything about the bail bond system? That was not my $10,000.
Whose was it then? The Tooth Fairy?
I went to a bail bondsman. All I had to do was to put up 10% of that money, and I had to borrow that from a friend. But if you skip town, I'll have to pay back the entire amount, and believe me, I'll be paying it back for years.
Yeah, not as many years as they'll put me away for if I don't run away.
You don't know that.
Look, I did mug that lady. That's good for 5 years stretching a joint for sure. Now, don't answer it.
I've got to.
No, you don't.
Now, look, Marcus, I had a date tonight, and my boyfriend is a cop. Now, I was supposed to meet him downstairs right about now. If I don't answer that phone, he's going to worry about me, and he might come up here. Now, you don't want that kind of trouble now, do you?
All right, answer. Tell him you got to work late.
Scott and Nelson, attorneys at law, Dee Dee Bannister speaking.
My. Don't you sound official?
Hello, Calvin.
Hi.
I called your apartment, but I didn't get any answers, so I figured a legal crusader like yourself was probably burning the midnight oil.
Yes, I am pretty busy right now.
Yeah, well, you know what they say about all work and no play. Listen, why don't you let me drag you away from those briefs and subpoenas and stuff?
I don't think I can make it tonight, Calvin.
Come on, you can even take the picture. you have to buy a popcorn, but what could be fairer?
I'm very selective when it comes to movies.
Yeah, okay.
The only movie I would even consider seeing tonight is The Beatles' Second Picture.
The what?
You know, The Beatles' Second Picture. It's that or nothing, Calvin. Goodbye. There, I think that got rid of him.
Don't jive me, lady. I know you got money. You got lots of money, and I need some of it fast.
Marcus, you're an ingrate. I took your case for almost no fee at all, and I stuck my neck out to get that bail bond for you. And now you tell me that you're going to jump bail and stick me for the money?
It's better than me getting stuck in jail.
And you have the nerve to come here and ask me for more money?
I got to get away. I asked my old lady for the money, but like you said, she's dead broke.
And you'll break her heart if you do this.
Don't talk to me about breaking no hearts. I'm going to break some heads if you don't give me some cash.
Well, where am I going to get it? Here's my purse. Here. Take it. Take everything that's in it. And even if I had money in the bank, which I don't, they're all closed at night, in case you didn't know.
You got as much as the old lady. You better come up with another way. And right now, because I'm not fooling around. Now, you give me some money. What's in this guy?
There's nothing in here but some old papers, some paper clips, some candy.
Okay, let's see.
See, there's nothing in there.
What about those other doors? Open them.
See, there's nothing in there either.
All right, police officer, hold it. Come on now, just put that knife down, son.
You put the gun down. Do you hear me, cop? I said drop the gun.
All right, we'll make a deal. I'll put the gun down. Put the knife down, and we'll talk about it nice and calm, all right?
Don't put it down, cop. I told you to drop it on the floor.
Calvin, please.
Yeah, okay. Anything you say, here you go. Now, how's that, huh? All right, now, somebody wants to tell me what's going on here?
He's my client.
You're a client. Uh-huh. What's the matter, Sonny? Can't you afford the fee?
Better stop calling me Sonny. Your lady friend's gonna get hurt.
Okay, just take it easy. There's no need for anybody to get hurt. I mean, you two are having some sort of legal dispute. I can negotiate it with you, huh? Why don't you just put that thing down and we can talk.
He doesn't want to talk, Calvin. He wants money.
He's really a cop.
Yeah, you want to see my badge? It's right here in my wallet with my money.
Toss it to me.
Here it is. Quick move there, lady. Thank you. 0195, Sona. Requesting assistance under 800 River Avenue, professional building, suite 1500. No, all I need is one patrolman in the car. That's right. Oh, you all right?
Thanks, and thank you for getting my message.
Oh, yeah, that was pretty clever of you. Second Beatles movie. Good thing there was a Beatles fan there, or I didn't know the name of it. Is this punk really a client of yours?
Yeah. I raised his bail, and I guess he thought I was one of those millionaire lawyers.
So you go out of your way to help him, and this is how he repays you, huh? Still feeling compassionate?
Hey, come on. It's over. It's over. It's all right.
Prepared to give you an answer to that question than I was to have lunch with you today.
I have a reason for being insistent, Dee Dee. I have to have an answer soon. You see, I may be leaving Monticello.
After playing against some pretty tall competition, you'd probably think I shower with the deodorant soap. Not anymore.
6400, Charles Schwab, a Bank America company. Member SIPC.
You're leaving Monticello. Why? What's happened?
Well, actually, it's a bit of good luck. I've been offered a position with a prestigious firm in Chicago.
Julius, that's wonderful. I'm really happy for you.
I'll have to give up some of the independence that I've enjoyed here, but in the long run, I'll gain a lot more in money and advancement.
Congratulations. You deserve it. It sounds like a great opportunity.
Well, congratulations are in order. But only if you'll come with me. If you'll say yes to my question.
Julius, I really haven't had a chance to think.
We could have a terrific life together in Chicago. It's a great town, you know? Everything in the world anyone can ask for in the way of opportunities. And the challenges are unlimited.
But this is my home now. This is where I've started to build my career, my partnership with Cliff.
Dee Dee, what did Cliff do before you joined forces? And you can build a bigger career in Chicago. A big city has a bigger crime problem. And they need more and better good lawyers, you know. Don't you see?
Oh, Julius, you do make it sound tempting.
I mean to.
But that's not fair. It was a tough enough question to answer before, and now it's even twice as difficult.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it would be easy. It all seemed so perfect.
I'm sorry, too. But if you need your answer in a hurry, then the answer has to be no.
Well, I'm not in that much of a hurry. Thought, Dee Dee, I don't want to complicate things when they're really very simple. I love you, that's all.
Oh, Julius, I'm so sorry. I guess I just need more time.
Is it, Well, I haven't actually accepted the position yet. In fact, if you make staying here a condition, then so be it. I'll take you, Dee Dee, not the job.
I like having clean clothes.
What cycle are we in?
I don't know. I just wait till the little red light goes off.
It's very complicated, isn't it?
Not really. You just put in the quarters.
No, I don't mean the washing machine. I mean the situation between you and Julius and Calvin.
Well, that's not nearly so complicated as it is complex.
Well, tell me more about your lunch with Julius.
Mitzi, I've told you all there is to tell.
Well, yeah, tell me again, though. I mean, you might have missed something.
Okay. Julius was offered a terrific job by a big law firm in Chicago, and he needed an answer right away as to whether or not I would marry him.
Chicago? Oh, Dee Dee, not Chicago.
What's wrong with Chicago? I hear it's a terrific city. It's very progressive. They even have a woman mayor.
No, you wouldn't like it.
How do you know? Have you ever been to Chicago?
Oh, no. And I don't want to go. Because if I went to Chicago, I might like it, and I would just hate that.
Clarence Darrow once said the very same thing about spinach.
A very wise man.
Oh, Mitzi, you're wonderful.
Thank you. Anyway, Dee Dee, if you went to Chicago, I'd have to find a new roommate. Besides, what would Calvin do?
Well, for one thing, you would simply find a new roommate, and Calvin would have to content himself with his wife. Remember her? The actress? She's in New York doing a play on Broadway.
Well, what did you tell her, Julius? Yes or no?
I told him that I could not possibly go to Chicago. That I spent too much time building my career here, and besides, I like it in Monticello.
All right. So, what did Julius have to say to that?
Well, Julius said that if I married him and didn't want to move to Chicago,
he wouldn't take the job.
Well, he must love you a lot to make such a sacrifice.
Yeah.
Julius is a very intelligent man, and he's going to be very rich. Yeah. Oh, Dee Dee, I gotta go. I've got an acting class.
Oh, well, that's okay. I'll finish up here.
I'd really appreciate it. And I promise, next time, I'll do the whole thing all by myself.
Yeah, okay. Okay, bye-bye.
Oh, Dee Dee.
Yeah.
You know, if you marry Julius, you never have to do your own laundry.
Thanks a lot, Mitzi. Besides, I'll have you know I like doing my own laundry, and my own cooking, and my own cleaning, and spending 12 hours a day in the office. I'm today's new woman, and I can do it all. This is my new white blouse.
The brass candlestick holder. Don't cry now. Tears won't help you. We're not impressed.
Oh, but I am. That was very good. What case are you working on?
Oh, well, it's not a case. It's a part in a play. She's more to be pitied than usual. We're doing it at the acting class tonight.
And what role are you playing?
I'm the villain.
Of course.
Well, you don't think it's going to ruin my image, do you? Oh, Dee Dee, I'm in real trouble. I told Mitzi I'd be ready to do this tonight, and with Gavin Wiley's case and everything else, I haven't had time to do anything about it.
Hey, well, hi-ho, everybody.
Oh, hi-ho.
If you're about to ask me to leave, I am here on business. How you doing, Cliff?
Oh, fine. Now, what's up?
Well,
The brass candlestick holder. Oh, don't cry now. Tears won't help you. We're not impressed.
Oh, but I am. That was very good. What case are you working on?
Oh, well, it's not a case. It's a part in a play. She's more to be pitied than usual. We're doing it at the acting class tonight.
And what role are you playing?
I'm the villain.
Of course.
Well, you don't think it's going to ruin my image, do you? Oh, Dee Dee, I'm in real trouble. I told Mitzi I'd be ready to do this tonight, and with Gavin Wiley's case and everything else, I haven't had time to do anything about it.
Hey, well, hi-ho, everybody.
Oh, hi-ho.
If you're about to ask me to leave, I am here on business. How you doing, Clint?
Oh, fine. What's up?
Well, I just thought you might be interested in something that Tyler found out last night.
Great, what is it?
Well, it turns out that, Nora Fulton, who is Nicole Kavanaugh's secretary, is an old girlfriend of none other than, ta-da, Mr. Gunther Wagner. Well, I didn't expect anybody to jump up and down, but I thought you'd at least show some mild interest.
Uh-huh. In what?
His mind is on acting classes.
Acting?
Oh, it's wonderful, really. I'm having a good time here. You ought to try it.
Thanks, but, I think one performer in the family is enough. Oh, Star's Play opened in New York last night. It turns out it's going to be a hit. As a matter of fact, I have got a copy of the rave review.
Great!
So.
How about that?
Star is a star. Congratulations.
Let me see that. Wow, New York, Broadway. Star Wilson lives up to her name. Bright young talent. Be seeing a lot of her. Yeah, looks like Star won't be back to Monticello for a while. I guess that solves the problem between you two. Well, I'm sorry. That was really gauche. Calvin, I apologize. Dee Dee, I think it's time we made an exit.
Is that why you came by here, Calvin, to tell me about your wife's success?
No, Dee Dee. I came by here to ask you about you and Julius. I figured by now you must have made some decision about whether you're going to say yes or no.
Well, Julius is moving to Chicago, so he needed an answer right away.
Chicago. I see.
He got a terrific new job. Lots of prestige, lots of money. But since I don't want to leave Monticello, I had to tell him no.
No?
No.
You know, that's the first time I think I've been glad to hear you say no.
Well, it's just a rehearsal hall now, but eventually it's gonna be a first-rate theater. Just wait and see.
Oh, I do love your...
Let's take it from the page 22. Okay, top of the page.
Beginning with your line or mine?
There's only one line at the top of page 22, and it's mine.
All right, hit it.
Why don't you hold book for us? Well, that means when we need a line or a cue, we ask you. Give it to us, okay?
Sure. Yeah, I won't need it.
Mitzi, you might. You don't know. Ready? State your name.
Line, please.
Elizabeth Abercrombie.
Don't you know the name of the character you're playing?
Well, yeah, but you asked me so fast, I forgot.
Okay, all right, okay, let's do it. Ready? Again. State your name.
Elizabeth Abercrombie.
Occupation.
Private secretary.
Private secretary to whom?
Mr. Harrison Pettigrew.
Just the deceased, I see.
Yes.
Just how private a secretary were you to Mr. Pettigrew?
Oh, wait a second, I object.
Let me object. There's nothing in the script that says I object.
No, but any defense attorney worth his fee would object at this point. You are clearly badgering the witness.
I know that, Dee Dee, but I don't write them, I just act them.
Well, why didn't the author do a little research then?
Ask him.
He's dead.
He is? Oh. Can we get on with this?
Fine. All right.
Just how private a secretary were you to Mr. Pettigrew?
I simply handled his... correspondence. That's all.
Do you type?
No.
Do you take shorthand?
No.
I see. Where were you on the night of September the 18th?
At home. In bed.
Alone? Answer the question, Miss Abercrombie.
Alone.
Can you prove that?
Can you prove I wasn't?
It's not up to me to prove it, Miss Abercrombie. You were in love with Mr. Pettigrew, were you not?
Yes!
And on the night of September the 18th, a Thursday, you went to his house for your usual weekly assignation, did you not?
No! 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 No!
That's too early, Mitzi.
Sorry.
A Thursday, you went to his house for your usual weekly assignation, did you not?
No, I told you
don't lie, Miss Abercrombie. You went there and you argued, and in your anger and your passion, you grabbed the brass candlestick in your hand, you raised it above his head, and trembling in anticipation, you struck the fatal blow. Now.
No! 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 No!
Curtain.
Well, did she kill Mr. Pettigrew or not?
Well, I don't know. You see, we haven't read the third act yet. Oh. I love something. Dee Dee, you want anything?
Mm-mm. No, thanks.
You want something?
Yeah.
I'll get it.
Okay. Dee Dee, thanks for helping us. Appreciate it.
Oh, sure. I enjoyed it. Besides, it took my mind off my own private little drama for a while.
Dee Dee, are you unhappy about your decision not to marry Julius?
No. No, I know I did the right thing. Julius wanted that job in Chicago, and I had to say no.
Well, that is what I call a noble sacrifice.
Well, the truth is, if I had been crazy about Julius, I would have done it.
You would have gone to Chicago with him?
Absolutely not. I would have insisted that he stay here in Monticello.
Dee Dee, you're a tough cookie.
Yeah, well, don't kid yourself. I'm not as tough as you.
Hey, girl! Open up! Open up! Open up, girls! Hide! Cliff!
Hi.
Cliff, there he is! You guys came to see me!
Brace yourself, Cliff! Brace yourself! We have the most wonderful news in the whole world.
I am going to be a free man! What do you mean? What are you talking about? Huh?
Well,
what are you saying?
It's his story, Cliff. I guess I better let him tell you.
Well, that sounds like a cause for celebration. I'll go get the champagne. We have some left over from the house.
Oh, yeah. Oh, just calm down. Right. I'm gonna sit down on the couch and explain to me everything.
So, Calvin, what is all the excitement? What's the
story?
Oh,
we just discovered some new evidence in Gavin's case. You know, the thing is, really, if the law is gonna accept it, I guess the first hurdle is getting the chief to find it pertinent, you know? But I'll fill you in about those details later. What I want to talk to you about is, the fact that I think you did a real fine thing, making it so easy for Julius to take that job in Chicago.
You know, between you and Mitzi telling me how fine and noble I am, I think I'm about ready to sprout wings and a halo.
You know, I don't seem to be able to do anything right with you. You're giving me hell because I just paid you a compliment.
Well, the truth is, Calvin, if I had loved Julius, I would have gone with him. But I don't love Julius. At least not that way.
Could there be somebody else that you love that way?
Yeah, there is. There's this guy with a funny little smile and big brown eyes and a crazy sense of humor. And he's kind of cute and he's kind of sexy and he's very warm.
Didi, what are you saying?
Oh, Calvin, don't you know that I love you?
He's getting the keys to the theater today. Terrific. We'll have a party then. On stage, of course. We'll bring candles or a flashlight. Look, Mitzi, I will go get fireflies and put them in a jar. Has he mentioned anything about who's going to cast in the first production yet? Well, no, I mean, I know that's part of the agreement, but no, I can't. Oh, you know me, when it comes to hammers and nails, they call me Thumbs Nelson. No, I can't. But don't start. Come on, don't start. Don't. All right, I'll think about it, okay? I'll see you at Sid's tonight. You working? Well, good. That means I won't have to pay. That was a joke, Mitzi. Yeah, bye. Did you hear that?
In this gigantic office? How could I?
Terrific! It's true. He's signing the papers with Sky Whitney. We are going to have a theater.
We?
Well, yeah, he hasn't officially announced the opening of the theater group, but I'm sure he will.
And you're just assuming that you will be a part of it?
Yeah, after all I went through last time, you betcha.
And you didn't learn your lesson the last time?
Well, that stuff about Raven, that won't happen again. All that crazy scam business, never.
You know what's even crazier? The idea of your playing Cliff Barrymore again.
Dee Dee, you have never seen me act. There's no reason at all why I can't be the next Barrymore or less.
Cliff, do you remember what happened to your law practice the last time you got involved in show business?
Yeah, I know, I let it slide a little.
Oh, I'll say you let it slide right on into the...
Dee Dee, look at this, huh? Look at that. It's a decision on the Harris case in my favor. Now, that is going to pay rent for a few months. And I got 3 corporate clients while I was in Chicago. You know, it is summertime outside. There's a recession going on. This is always a slow time. Don't worry about it, all right? Dee Dee, I'll be careful. Besides, there's not going to be much acting going on in that theater anyway for a while.
Oh, yeah, why not?
Well, one of the conditions of the lease is that Jim has to renovate the theater. Now, that is going to take a lot of hard work.
Then I don't have to worry. You definitely won't get involved.
That's cool. It's untrue. It's uncalled for. Just for that, you can take me to lunch.
Wrong.
Oh, why not?
Because Calvin is coming by.
Oh-ho.
Oh-ho. He wants to talk to me about one of my clients.
Oh, of course. This is just purely a business meeting.
Yes, this is a business meeting.
Well, that's good. Because then it doesn't matter.
What doesn't matter?
Well, it doesn't matter about your hair, Dee Dee.
What about my hair?
Well, your hair, it's all messed up.
Cliff!
All right, hold it right there, Sonny.
And you know, you don't look at all like my old man.
Put it back.
It was just candy.
Put it back, and then take the change out of your pocket and put it back in the drawer.
And what change?
The money you just took out of the drawer, man. I'm not gonna tell you twice.
Yeah, and who are you, the house detective? I thought they only had those in hotels.
it close enough. I'm a cop, Detective Monticello PD. Now, does that help you change your mind?
Well, I think I have to go now. Oh, yeah, the change. And here you are, my good man. You buy yourself a rubber hose.
You aren't going anywhere.
Man, it was only a joke.
Yeah. Try laughing at this. Assume the position. Hit it! Come on, you've done it before.
Helen, what are you doing?
You know, you really ought to keep your door locked. There are lots of sneak thieves all over this building.
Yeah, you hear that, Dee Dee?
You know him?
I am no thief, officer. I'm her brother.
As a matter of fact, Calvin, he's both.
Well, I was just looking for some paper, that's all. See, I wanted to leave my sister a note telling her I came by to see you.
I see. Well, I hope the problem with your vision is nothing permanent, Troy, since the pad's been sitting right on top of the desk the entire time.
What do you know about that? Yeah, you know, it's funny, isn't it, the way something can be right in front of your eyes the whole time and you can't see it.
Yeah, funny, isn't it?
I take it Dee Dee didn't know that you were coming by here today.
You know, you got my letter, didn't you?
Yes, I got your letter. I knew you were getting out of... I knew that you were coming to see me, but you didn't mention the exact day.
Then I will mention it now. It's today.
Yeah, well, look, Dee Dee, since obviously you're busy, why don't we postpone our meeting till some other time, okay?
Yes, Calvin, maybe we should.
Oh, look, Nancy, I hate for you to leave on my account, Detective Stoner, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's
well,
right.
It was a nice meeting you anyway. You know, this is the first time I ever got frisked by a cop and then shook his hand.
Yeah. Well, I'll, see you later.
Yeah, goodbye, Calvin. Well, congratulations. You almost pulled off the neatest trick of the week. Getting yourself arrested the day after you get yourself released.
Well, is he your boyfriend, Dee Dee?
No, he is not my boyfriend. He is a police officer, and he was here to see me about a client. And it's a good thing he's a very, very nice man, because you might have ended up being one of my clients, too.
Wait, you once said you can't handle your own brother's cases.
And it's a good thing, too, because I like innocent defendants.
You wouldn't handle a case of mine no matter what, Dee Dee, since you don't care that much about what happens to me.
Troy! Don't say that because it isn't true, and you know it's not fair.
Look, you haven't seen me in over a year. And what kind of reception do I get? I get frisked by that cop friend of yours and put down by you. Look, you know, maybe I should have just stayed away.
Well, maybe you should have. Troy! Troy, I'm sorry. You know I'm glad to see you.
Dee Dee, I didn't have anywhere else to go but here. Look, I had to get out of that place.
I'm glad you're here. And like I told you in my letter, I'm going to do everything that I can to help you. But Troy, you've got to help me too, okay? Now will you please try a little harder this time? Now look, before you say yes, make sure that you mean it. Look, Troy. Will you try to make an honest living for a change? Oh, Troy.
Look, I am sorry if I kept you waiting.
That's okay. I had lots to keep me busy. Now, what is it that you wanted to talk to me about, Calvin?
Well, I've been curious about a couple of things. They have to do with your brother, Troy.
Why the interest about my brother, Calvin? He's paid his dues. He's out of prison now. He's looking for a job, not trouble. And the less interest that a cop has in him, the better.
Hey, look. I didn't come here to start any trouble. As a matter of fact, I came to try and help prevent it for his sake as well as yours.
Well, don't worry about him. He will be just fine.
Yeah, well, that may be, Dee Dee, but from what I observed in this office the other day...
No, wait a second. Just because you saw him going through my desk does not mean he is John Dillinger.
Hey, I never said that. Come on, calm down. Why are you so defensive about Troy? I'm here because I want to help him, not drag him down.
I'm sorry, Calvin, you're right. I am defensive about Troy. I'm worried about him. I love him, and I would do anything in the world to help him. But I just don't know what to do to straighten him out.
Yeah, well, the decision really is going to have to be his own. I mean, with some support, he'll probably work out okay.
I can't do it by myself, Calvin. I've got my own life. I cannot watch him every minute of every day.
Yeah, well, see, that's where I come in. I figured that maybe I could sort of, you know, keep an eye out for him. I mean, I'm not sure exactly how, but at least I could try.
You mean you would do that for my brother? Thanks, Calvin. I would be very grateful.
Yeah? Grateful enough to have dinner with me sometime?
Look, Calvin, don't try to bargain with me, all right? Don't put a price tag on a very nice gesture.
Dee Dee, it was just a friendly invitation.
Calvin, you know why I can't see you socially. Your wife is coming home soon, isn't she?
Dee Dee, wait, look. I came here to say something. I want you to know that, in spite of everything, Dee Dee, I still love you very much. Don't respond. Just promise me you'll remember that, okay?
Hi, sis. Officer.
Hi, Troy.
Hi, Troy.
I thought I'd drop in, just checking in, you know? Hey,
yeah.
Look, don't let me scare you off.
No, I was just leaving.
Goodbye, Calvin.
Yeah, so long, Dee Dee.
So long, man.
Yeah, take it easy.
You know, he's all right for a cop.
Yeah. So, what's going on with you? What's happening?
Good things, Dee Dee. And you are going to be one happy lady.
Yeah, well, don't keep me in suspense.
You see before you a working man. I got a job.
Oh, Troy, that's wonderful. That's wonderful. Doing what?
No, it's just sort of a girlfriend. A friend of mine got it for me, but it's going to work out just fine. And no more worrying from now on.
That's great. Oh, that is great.
Say, Dee Dee, that a cop, Stoner, that just left,
Yeah, what about him?
Well, he does seem to hang around here a lot, doesn't he? I mean, there ain't nothing going on between you.
Listen, little brother, that is strictly a business relationship, okay? He's married.